Do you remember the coronation scene at the end of The Return of the King? Well, I mean, toward the end of The Return of the King. Anyway, this scene has always made me cry. You bow to no one. And I know I'm not the only one. Don't lie to me. So, why does this scene make us cry? I mean, it's certainly heartwarming. The little hobbits we've come to know and love are finally getting the recognition that they deserve. Everyone's celebrating, it's happily ever after and all that. It really is delightful, right? But it goes deeper than just that. In fact, I would go so far as to say that from Tolkien's perspective, this is the most important scene in the entire story. To understand why, let's talk about eucatastrophe in The Lord of the Rings.
Eucatastrophe.
If you're unfamiliar with the word eucatastrophe, a little explanation is in order. The word is actually a Tolkien original, like hobbit or tween. True story. Well, a catastrophe is a sudden turn to disaster, right? So Tolkien coined eucatastrophe as the sudden happy turn in a story which pierces you with a joy that brings tears. Things are looking bleak, and then good triumphs over evil. We usually think about it as the climax of a story. The Emperor gets the shaft, Voldemort gets vaporized, Ursula gets stabbed by a boat. So in this case, it would be the destruction of the ring, right? Well, I think that certainly counts as a eucatastrophe, but if we dig a little deeper, we'll see that, according to Tolkien at least, the real moment comes a bit later. While there are actually many eucatastrophes in The Lord of the Rings, the coronation scene stands apart as the eucatastrophe. If you care to follow along, it is in Book 6 in The Return of the King. It's Chapter 4, The Field of Cormallan. But first, let's go back to the letter in which he defined eucatastrophe. Right after that, Tolkien, an extremely devout Catholic, goes on to say that the resurrection is the greatest eucatastrophe possible in the greatest fairy story. Now, I'm not a Catholic like Tolkien, but I still think I see what he's getting at. In the Christian tradition, death is the ultimate evil, and the resurrection is Christ's triumph over it. So it's that sudden turn from darkness to light. And more than that, in Catholic theology, Christ's resurrection means that he has broken the bonds of death, so not only does he get to live again, but so does everyone else, even after death. And now we shift to the subject of death in The Lord of the Rings.
Death in The Lord of the Rings.
Many of you are familiar with the imagery that Tolkien used for death. You'll remember the scene in the movies when Gandalf is describing death to Pippin. He says, "It's not so bad." He talks about a veil of silver glass. And beyond that, a far green country under a swift sunrise. In the books, we actually see this imagery twice. Once when Frodo sails to the Undying Lands in the final chapter, and then once early on in the House of Tom Bombadil when Frodo sees it in a dream. But there's actually a third instance of this imagery, and it took me almost 20 years of reading to finally notice it. And when I did, it kind of blew my mind. It's actually during that coronation chapter. So let's set the scene. Frodo wakes up after the destruction of the ring and is reunited with his friends. He and the others are informed by Gandalf that Aragorn's coronation is happening, and they are expected to attend. It's taking place on the Field of Cormallan, not Minas Tirith like in the movie. It's a lovely little spot in Ithilien on the way back to Minas Tirith from their battle at the Black Gate. When they arrive, they come out of a grove of trees into a wide green land, and beyond it was a broad river in a silver haze. Sound familiar? Yeah, there it is again, the silver curtain and the green country. But this time, if you pay attention close, they're reversed. In the other instances, Frodo approaches a metaphorical death, peeking through the silver curtain to the far green country. This time, on the Field of Cormallan, he's already in the green country, looking at the silver curtain from the other side. So in this scene, we're seeing death from the other side. Other moments of the story are poignant and emotional in their own way, but this is where we get something of real religious significance close to Tolkien's heart. This is Tolkien's belief or hope of what we'll see after we die, not just as we approach death. So what is on the other side of that silver curtain? Well, there are two other major characters in this scene besides the hobbits. We have Gandalf and Aragorn. Now, Gandalf has been described by Tolkien as an angel, and Aragorn obviously takes the place of Jesus here. He's defeated the great evil, taken his place as king, and is welcoming the hobbits into his realm. And not just him, but a whole trumpet-blaring, praise-shouting, angelic host. And if that isn't enough religious imagery for you, there's more. Oh, there's more. Gandalf has already been established as Gandalf the White, but Tolkien takes care in this scene to give him one more angelic description. Robed in white, his beard now gleaming like pure snow. And just like a Catholic angel, Gandalf is now in the role of messenger and servant of the king. So it makes perfect sense when Gandalf tells Sam that he's there to bring Sam and Frodo to the king. And to really drive the religious stuff home, just before the hobbits are brought to meet the king, they're washed, clad, and eat a light meal. Clearly references to baptism and communion. And you know, we don't have to go the religious route here. This scene would qualify as the story's ultimate eucatastrophic moment, even just on narrative terms. Remember that Tolkien's definition of a eucatastrophe is a sudden happy turn. And you could object that this is a full 2 weeks after the destruction of the ring. So maybe we just have to stretch our definition of the word sudden. But you don't have to. Consider the structure of the narrative here. The chapter doesn't begin with Sam and Frodo waking up in Ithilien. It begins with the immediate aftermath of the ring's destruction. The Nazgul flee, the enemy's forces are routed, the earth shakes, and Mount Doom erupts. Then we zoom in on a tender moment between Frodo and Sam when they finally lay down to die amid all the lava and ash. Things are so bleak, even Sam has finally given up hope of a return journey. But then Gandalf and several eagles arrive, pick them up, and carry them back to Aragorn. Then the story moves immediately ahead to when they wake up, just in time for the coronation. So from the reader's perspective, the happy turn really is quite sudden. In one chapter, in one page really, we go from hell on earth to, well, paradise really. So we could make the argument for this scene being the ultimate eucatastrophe in The Lord of the Rings just based on the narrative structure and leave out the religious angle. But ultimately, because this is Tolkien, it is about the religious angle. And from Tolkien's, again, very Catholic perspective, this scene is the culmination of everything. When we're trying to look from a Christian perspective, we might be tempted to look for a moment in the story that symbolizes Christ's resurrection. After all, that's what Tolkien said was the ultimate eucatastrophe, right? So it makes sense if we're looking for one, but there isn't really a moment in the story that fits that. And that's okay, because in Christian theology, the resurrection means more than just that Jesus died and rose again. The entire idea is that he conquered death for everyone. So the Field of Cormallen is when all people, represented here by the hobbits, see the benefit of the resurrection personally. Tolkien's eucatastrophe is when the hobbits, who have been through hell almost literally, are welcomed into the presence of the king. Now think of it this way, from the Catholic perspective, maybe you share it, maybe you don't, the world is a dark and sinful place. Even if our daily experience isn't quite Mordor, even if we live a nice quiet life in the Shire or some other sleepy part of the world, darkness is constantly threatening, constantly encroaching. That's life. That's what we've been born into. Or we could go even further and say that life here is symbolized by the ring itself. We're all in Frodo's shoes, asked to make our way from the peaceful life of the Shire through the darkness of the world all the way into Mordor. If we acquit ourselves well, we're welcomed into the embrace of the king at the end, to great glory and fanfare. It's very much a well done, thou good and faithful servant moment. And that is why we all cry during the coronation. As far as I'm concerned, you don't have to be a believer to see the beauty in that story. Hey, if you liked this video, then do me a favor and like it. I've got lots more videos like this in the works, so be sure to subscribe. If you want to support what we do at The Legendarium, one of the best things you can do is share our stuff. So hit that share button down there and spread this around on the socials. And lastly, a huge shout out to our Patreon members. Thank you all so much for your support. All right, I will see you next time.